Welcome to TSplus Remote Access, the smarter alternative to Citrix and Microsoft RDS. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to generate a customized portable client to seamlessly connect users to their remote environment. Let's dive in. To begin, open the portable client generator. You'll find it on your desktop after installing TSplus Remote Access. You can also launch it from the admin tool. Just go to the Sessions tab and click on Client Generator. Once the program is opened, you'll land on the General tab, where you'll set up the core connection details. Start by entering the server's IP address. The default port is 3389, but you can change it if needed. Then enter the user's login and password. This makes the connection seamless, without prompting for credentials each time. If you're using a domain, you can include it here too. To customize the login process, the Windows Client Generator offers a few smart login options. To prevent credentials from being saved, type "no save credential" as the username. For full auto-login, use *SSO in the username field. The client will ask for credentials once, then remember them. To use the current local user's Windows login, simply enter **, or %username% in the logon field. To hide the login window entirely, type "no password" in the password field. Next, choose your preferred display mode. Classic Remote Desktop provides full access to the remote environment, ideal when multiple apps or system tools are needed. Remote App shows only selected applications, appearing as if they're installed locally. It's great for focused, secure access. Performance settings can be adjusted based on your network. Disable background animations for slower connections, or select fast network or fiber optic for full visuals when bandwidth allows. At the bottom, you'll see the client creation tool, always available no matter which tab you're viewing. We'll return to this at the end. The second tab, named Display, allows you to customize the visual settings of your remote session for optimal appearance. Select your preferred color depth, from 15 to 32 bits, depending on the quality you want. Enable dual screen mode if needed and decide whether the session should span across both monitors. You can also turn on shortcut keys for easier navigation during the session. The Remote Desktop Client tab allows you to control how the session is displayed. Pick from preset resolutions, define a custom size, or allow the session to match the screen automatically. There's also a full screen option for a more immersive feel. You can scale the display from 100 to 500% and enable smart sizing to make the desktop fit any window. Additionally, you can choose to keep the local taskbar visible. If you're using multiple monitors, simply select which one will display the session. Just keep in mind, these settings only apply to Remote Desktop Client mode, not Remote App. In the Local Resources tab, you can decide which of the user's local devices should be accessible during the session. Let's begin with disks. If the checkbox is selected but the field is empty, all local drives will be redirected. If you want to limit access to specific drives, simply enter the letters of the drives you wish to allow. To include multiple drives, separate each letter with a comma, like this for CDE. You can also redirect local printers, audio, COM ports, smart cards, and USB devices. For audio, choose whether sound plays on the local machine, on the remote server, or not at all. The Portable Client Generator offers three printing options with the Universal Printer. You can preview with a local PDF reader, print to the default printer, or select one manually. You can also decide how pages are scaled, keep the original size, fit to printable area, or shrink to fit. The next section, named Program, allows you to set a specific application to launch automatically when the session starts. Simply enter the path to your application or click Browse to locate it. the start directory will be filled in automatically. You can also add any command line parameters as needed. However, for more flexibility, we recommend assigning applications through the admin tool. It's easier to manage and update. Let's look at the security settings. You can lock the client to a specific computer name and/or tie it to a hardware serial number. You can also set how long the client stays valid after first use. Below that, you'll find even more controls. Block credentials saving entirely or allow users to keep just their username. Enable two-factor authentication for extra protection. Turn on encryption V2 to secure sessions with 128-bit encryption. Turn on Windows Single Sign-On for seamless login, so users don't have to re-enter credentials. Finally, you can set the targeted server as a secure gateway. Use the domain name instead of the IP address, and ensure that an SSL TLS certificate is properly installed. Finally, the load balancing tab helps distribute sessions across servers for better performance. To turn it on, just check the box. The gateway will then route users to the right server automatically. Also, set the gateway web port. It should match across all servers. By default, it's port 80. Important, only enable this feature if load balancing is already set up in your environment. For detailed instructions, check out our documentation. Now that everything is configured, it's time to create your custom client. First, choose where to save the file. Then give it a name. Finally, click Create Client to generate your personalized .connect file. It will be created using the settings you've just configured. Now the user can simply launch the file and connect instantly, no extra setup needed. Thank you for watching. To learn more about the Portable Client Generator in TSplus Remote Access, explore our technical documentation at tsplus.net.